Do you know how to use the class tracking feature in QuickBooks Online? This special tool will help you categorize your transactions in the way that your small business or your home family's financial situation needs you to. In fact, this tool can even help you estimate your taxable income. One of the greatest things that QuickBooks Online can do for you, if you're using it to manage your personal home finance, is to separate the income and expenses that belong on your tax return from the income and expenses that do not belong on your tax return. Now, this will help you when making decisions, and it will also help the tax professional that you give your books and records to take the results, put on the form, and file your taxes for you. So, how do we separate that which belongs on the tax return from that which does not? Well, before we talk about how to do this in QuickBooks Online, let's talk a little bit about how taxes work. Sometimes when we receive money, it still counts as income that increases our personal net worth, but that particular income we do not have to include as income when filing our taxes. And it's the same thing on the other side with expenses. Sometimes we pay a legitimate expense that lowers our net income and net worth, but that particular expense we are not allowed to deduct. So, we need two separate profit and loss. We need a profit and loss that only includes taxable income and deductible expenses, and we can put the income that's not taxable and the expenses that are not deductible on a different profit and loss. This way, when we give our profit and loss to the accountant to do the taxes, only taxable income is in the income section and deductible expenses are in the expense section, so you would have at the bottom of that particular profit and loss a pretty good estimate, not a perfectly accurate number, but a pretty good estimate of what your taxable income is for that tax period.
So, you have to be sure that you classify income that's taxable separate from the non-taxable income.
Now, the way to do this in QuickBooks Online is to activate something called class tracking. This is a feature that allows you to add a little piece of data to every deposit that you record and every check or expense that you record to tell QuickBooks Online which class category this particular transaction is in. Then after we record the transaction with that little extra piece of data indicating which class category the transaction is in, we can then run a profit and loss for that specific class. So if we create two separate classes, one for deposits, expenses, and checks that will be included in the tax form, and another for deposits, expenses, and checks that will not be included in the tax form, then we can run a profit and loss for only the things that are included in the taxes and have a very good estimate of our annual taxable income. Let's take a look at how to do this in QuickBooks Online. So before we actually activate class tracking, let's take a look at what's not there that will be there after we activate class tracking. So if we go to the top right and click the cogwheel right now, and we go over to the column of lists, we see there is no class list. In fact, if we click all lists and open up the list of lists, you can see there is no list of classes right now because we have not yet activated it. Now, the way to activate the class list is to again click the cogwheel and go all the way over to where it says Account and Settings. Now, in the Settings window, all the way on the left panel, the very bottom choice is Advanced. Click on it, click OK, and you can see there are different sections of the Advanced Settings. The section that we want is the Category section. So, we click anywhere in the section to open it up, and you see where it says Track Classes. If you click it from gray to green, green means that it's activated. Now, that's all we need to do for now, and you can explore and experiment with the other options here later on. But after we click Save, you notice it says Track Classes is on, but you're not finished. It will not save the activation unless you additionally go to the bottom right of the Account Settings window and click Done. So now if we refresh the list of lists, you can now see that since we activated class tracking, classes are now on our list. Now we can open up the list of classes and see we don't have any classes yet because we just activated this now. So we're going to create two classes, includable and excludable. And when an item is includable on your taxes, like normal income and normal expenses, that will be the class we choose. But if an item is not includable, like a gift from income or some kind of expense that you cannot deduct, we will choose excludable class so that we can see exactly what we have as part of our estimating our taxable income. So, in order to put two classes on the class list, we click New. Now, the first one will be includable, capital, and that will be most of our income and expenses, and we'll click Save. Now, we click New, and we'll name the next one excludable, and then we click Save. And you will see that now that we've activated class tracking, whenever we go to make a deposit, check, or expense, there will be an additional field of data where we can choose whether we're including or excluding this transaction on the taxes before we save the transaction. Now, before we do our first transactions with class tracking, we also have to do one more very last step. We have to set up and customize and memorize the special profit and loss that separates things by class. And the name of the report that separates things by class is called the Profit and Loss by Class. Let's open it up and set it up as part of our custom reports so that after we make a transaction where we use class tracking, we can really see the results and how this works in the Profit and Loss by Class report. So we go to the left panel and click Reports. Now, we're trying to pull out from the standard area our new report, Profit and Loss by Class, and save it in the custom area. So that report should be in the Business Overview section of reports, and then it's right here, Profit and Loss by Class. It's there because we now activated the class feature. So we click on it, and in our class, we change it to All Dates and Run Report. And notice, right now, there are only two columns, because we have not yet had a transaction where we used one of the classes as the extra piece of data. But what we must do is click Save Customization. You can give it any name you want, but I like to leave the name and click Save. So now it will be very convenient to click Reports, Custom, and go down to Profit and Loss by Class after our first example transaction. So now let's do our first transaction using the class tracking that we just activated. Let's imagine on April 23rd, Serena's Aunt Tilly gave her $1,000 cash just as a gift. Well, even though I'm not a tax expert, I happen to know that the first $13,000 of cash gifts that you receive are not includable, or you are not required to include that income in your taxes. However, in your books and records, when you're keeping track of home finance, you must record that because it changes the balance of your bank account and it's still income even though it's not taxable. So let's take a look at how to record it. Now, because we have already activated class tracking, we could record this transaction either in the register or the deposit window. Both of them will have new additional fields for class tracking. But let's do it in the register because we're accustomed to it. We can click Transactions and then go to Chart of Accounts. Then we want to go View Register for specifically the Chase bank account that the $1,000 from Aunt Tilly came into. So we click View Register, and you can see there's a brand new column here for class tracking and even tracking location if you were to have activated location in the settings window. But we only activated class. Now, the new transaction is a deposit, and the date was April 23rd of 2026 in our little story. Now, the person who gave us the money was Aunt Tilly. You can add her on the fly, but you don't have to, okay? And you could put her a customer, vendor, or employee. She's giving the money, leave it as a customer. But most importantly, the account. What's the reason that we got this money? Well, it's income from gifts. And we don't have an income from gifts in the chart of account, but we can add it on the fly. So we click Add New, and obviously the account type is an income type, okay? And the detail type is just other. You don't want to put other income, have it go to the bottom, or other primary income, have it stay on the top of the income statement, profit and loss. It's totally your choice, but the name is gift income or income from gifts. Okay, save and close. Okay, good. Now, most importantly, the class is excludable. We will not include this gift on our taxes because every year a certain amount of cash is non-taxable if we receive it as a gift, and that amount changes every year. Okay, so the amount of this deposit is $1,000. And then, of course, we click Save. Now, of course, the trial balance will change, but the most important report to take a look at after this transaction is the profit and loss by class. So we click Reports, Custom, Profit and Loss by Class, and notice we have one amount in the excludable column, so anything in that column will be excludable rather than being taxed on it, and that will be the column that you can see has income and expenses that are not includable on your taxes. And in order to really make the point, let's do a second transaction.
This job is taxable even if I'm only a 1099 worker.
Hey Serena.
Hey, Danny, tonight's your night. There are free peanuts at the bar.
Free peanuts? Roadhouse.
So remember, income from Serena's job is taxable no matter what, even if a certain amount of cash gifts are not. So now let's try an example with an expense. Let's imagine on April 28, Serena paid $30 from her cash in wallet to McDonald's. And this particular meal is not deductible for taxes. Let's take a look at how we record it. And again, we could record this in the check window or expense window, and they would both have an extra field for class, but we might as well record this in the register because that has the class field as well. So again, we click Transactions, Chart of Accounts. Now this came from Serena's wallet, so we click View Register, and of course this is an expense, and we didn't really notice the number on the receipt at McDonald's, so that happens sometimes, but the payee was McDonald's. Clearly QuickBooks Online remembers its food expense. If it chooses a different expense from the one that we have here, you have to carefully look at it and change it yourself. But clearly, the class shows up as excludable because you can't always deduct your McDonald's from your taxes. And be careful. If it pre-fills the expense, it might accidentally pre-fill the payment amount, and you want to overtype it with the proper amount of this particular transaction, which, by the way, was on April 28 of 2026 in our little home finance story. But you could use class tracking for small business exactly the same way. So when we click Save, we could then go to Reports and Profit and Loss by Class. And notice, let's zoom in a little bit this time. And you can see this $30 she cannot deduct from her taxes, just like this $1,000 she doesn't have to include on her taxes, and so on. So that's the way you use the class tracking feature.